मेरा बसा बसाया घर तोड़ दिया है।
मैंने आपका घर नहीं तोड़ा, प्रेम खुद चलकर मेरे पास आए थे।
मैंने क्या किया तेरी वजह से मेरे बेटे?
दादी,
अ गर्लफ्रेंड इज ब्लेम्ड फॉर हर पार्टनर्स डेथ, अ मदर इज हेल्ड रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर हर सन्स ट्रांसग्रेशंस, अ वाइफ इज द रीजन बिहाइंड हर हस्बैंड्स पुअर परफॉर्मेंस एट वर्क। साउंड्स फैमिलियर राइट? The society world over perpetuates the stereotype that women are culpable for men's weakness, corruptibility and doom. The moral responsibility seems to weigh heavier on the women's scale always. But why? The psychological answer to this is scapegoating. It's easier to pin the blame on someone who is lower in the societal power hierarchy, someone who doesn't have the agency or voice to speak up and be heard, which in a patriarchal system happens to be women. Since the beginning of time, scapegoating women has been a very convenient way through which the patriarchal system allows men to escape accountability and responsibility for their behavior.
So if we look at the foundational story of original sin, Eve ate the apple, but she not only ate the apple, she is accused in Genesis of tempting Adam to eat the apple. Tertullian said women are the gateway of the devil. And then you kind of get this similar kind of cultural representations in literature. So in Greek mythology, you have Pandora opens the jar that inflicts all the evil on the world. Helen is blamed for the Trojan War. And then you get kind of real world scapegoating. So from the 1400s, we have tens of thousands of witches, usually women, usually old women, being burned alive and drowned, in all kinds of cultures around the world.
Closer home, Sita had to prove her chastity and integrity by walking through fire. In popular lore, Draupadi is often blamed for bringing out the Mahabharata war. Legends abound of beautiful apsaras who disturb meditating saints and are punished for it.
It's particularly common in cases of rape and sexual assault. We are very quick to blame victims, and it's absolutely, I'm sure you know, it's absolutely commonplace for people to say, well, if a woman was wearing a short skirt or she was flirting or she was drinking, she deserved to be raped or she was asking for it. That's something that we commonly say and commonly hear in society.
On the flip side, the other nuances, हर कामयाब आदमी के पीछे एक औरत का हाथ होता है, which is a discounted acknowledgement of women's unpaid labor and support, upheld as both virtue and sacrifice. It is the sentimentalization of women's oppression, making it harder for women to resist and fight back.
If women are also morally accountable for things that they haven't even done wrong, that's an extra burden, and it's just tiring, it's exhausting, and that makes their lives more difficult.
This cultural indoctrination results in long-term psychological impact, which also affects women's self-esteem and confidence at work. Women are harder on themselves and on other women too. They self-blame more easily, take fewer risks, and can often fear the limelight or getting dragged in situations uncalled for. This leads to women keeping silent at work and actively dropping out from better opportunities. To free women of the stereotype, there needs to be a cultural cleanse and deeply held social attitudes. On the judicial level, there needs to be stricter policies to protect women from media trials and witch hunting. And girls, don't let the fear of being blamed stop you from speaking up. Be fearless and speak up. It's the only way they'll hear you.